From the groom getting exposed by their baby mama mid-ceremony to giving their best mates a lap dance, here's how these weddings became disastrous. Kicking off today's video with our first clip where the groom seems to have run out of patience before the marriage even began, abhorrent how no one stepped in and knocked some sense into him. As shocking and disappointing as it is, stuff like this happens rather often, like in our next video. Again, not suitable to be a functioning member of society, let alone a husband. But grooms aren't the only ones who ruin the fun for the wedding. Sometimes it could be the overenthusiastic wedding guests too. Even a blind person can see that both of them clearly hate each other and don't want to be married. Well, the guy was creative. The missus said no cake on the face, so he opted for champagne instead.
Oh yeah, the cake.
Look out for the cake!
Yeah!
Wait, no!
No!
Looks like they're serving tea at the wedding too. Getting exposed for cheating on your partner with receipts and family around? She won't be recovering anytime soon.
Embarazo. Ustedes saben que voy a ser papá. Pero saben que se olvidaron de un pequeño detalle, mi amor. Acá tengo las pruebas de que no son 4 meses, sino 6 meses de gestación.
Hija, ¿qué es esto? ¿De qué está hablando tu esposo? Explícame, por favor.
Tranquila, Zoro, tranquila, mi amor. Quiero aclarar un pequeño detalle.
Angie, déjalo que termine de hablar mi hermano, por favor.
Salgamos y hablemos afuera. Abogado, continuemos. Acá tengo
Miguel, salgamos y hablemos
todo lo que
afuera,
es
por
la
favor.
Casa, el documento, Miguel. Que otra vez está acá a nombre mío, pero ¿cuál es el argumento
Miguel,
que yo tengo? Acá está la prueba.
Miguel, salgamos afuera.
Suegro, por favor.
¿De qué estás hablando?
De los 3 años de engaño que tuve.
Miguel,
yo.
No, hablemos, hija.
Sí,
hablemos
ya.
Afuera, por favor.
Hija, ¿de qué estás hablando? ¿Qué pasó?
Hablemos afuera.
Lo envío.
Le dije que no lo hagas así.
Está aquí. Mi amigo, con este desgraciado, no salías a la casa a visitar a mi hija.
Amigo. Que no se retire, porque esta fiesta es de ellos dos y no es mía.
¿Qué?
Ahí se lo dejo.
¿Qué? ¿Contigo, Carlos? ¿Qué? ¿Contigo, Carlos? ¿Qué?
¿Contigo, Carlos? ¿Qué?
¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué?
Again with the overenthusiastic guests. I love how the dog sensed the presence of love and knew it was where he belonged.
When this wedding was about to start, this stray dog who had an injured leg came and crashed it, taking a seat in the back and attending the wedding just like he was invited, even getting a little bored during the long ceremony. He had all of the guests' attention, and when the bride and groom came out after the wedding, he jumped up to them in excitement, even with his injury, making the newlyweds feel like he wanted to go home with them. And on that day, they decided to adopt him, getting him the medical treatment he needed, and is now a happy and healthy dog with the forever family.
Looks like the cow had some objections regarding the wedding. While we're on the wholesome track of marriages, take a look at this absolute green flag of a person.
Thank you all for coming. There's one last thing. It's not really a tradition. It's not something really that goes within Catholic Church or normal weddings. Come on. All right. Not only today did I marry your mom, but I accepted you as my daughter, and I promise to always take care of you. I know you've been wanting to call me dad for a long time, and just recently we said it's okay. And I want to give you this ring as my commitment to you as well, that I will always be there for you. And I promise to always take care of you. I promise to care for you, make sure no boys steal your hearts. And I got all those guys over there to take care of you too. You got Uncle Jacob, Uncle Donovan, Uncle Ben. No one's gonna mess with you, all right? You're all mine, just like your mom's all mine, okay? And I love you a lot.
Enough with the wholesome marriage stuff. Now let's be a bit more realistic and take a look at this snobby priest.
And in accordance with God's will, you do now confess it. We're still good, huh? Please, sirs, leave. Please.
Where do we meet?
Anywhere other than here.
Okay.
This is a solemn assembly, not a photography session. Please move, or I will stop.
You want me to leave?
Please. I will stop the ceremony if you do not get out of the way.
You want me to leave? I'll leave.
This is not about the photography. This is about God.
Yes.
Imagine paying the cameraman a decent amount of money to capture your lovely moments only for him to flip the camera during the most important one. Worst thing, there are no second takes. Personally, inserting sports stuff into the most important moments of your life seems a bit weird, but whatever sells their boat. There's a time and place for jokes, and this could be one of them, but looks like the authority didn't want that.
Ela está tirando foto, tem testemunho. Infelizmente, hoje a gente não vai casar.
Ai, amor, que
Where there's a will, there's a way for sure. Even if there isn't, there might be some white vine you can use to clean up a stain. Love the enthusiasm. Go girl, give us nothing. Getting exposed by your baby mama on your wedding day mid-ceremony? Quite an L, I'd say.
Do you personally promise before God and these witnesses that you will love her, love him, comfort him, honor, and obey him?
Really, Anthony? You're gonna act like you don't know me? Wait, you didn't take your safe meds today?
And after you got it all over to him,
and I got your baby here?
To him, all this dude,
Anthony, I know you hear me.
You better get out of my mama's wedding. What is wrong with you?
In our next clip, the adorable grandma sort of brain farted and got confused about what she was holding in what hand. However, it had no serious consequences.
I'm on grandma watch. She's only had one pin so far. She's only on the first pins. Leave her alone. That's one for you, thin fried.
Have you got it on camera? Look at it as a positive. We're going to get 250 quid from you being framed.
Speaking of adorable senior citizens, Grandpa seemed to be a total heartbreaker. Hide your ladies, everyone. Did anyone change the groom's nappy? Considering his behavior, he seems like he's in desperate need of it. Videographers seem to be one of the biggest dangers in a wedding lately, huh? Looks like the bride's sister swooned in a bit too much at the wedding. Oh well, good thing store-bought cakes exist, I guess. It's absolutely understandable if the couple goes feral over this major malfunction. The bride looks like she has to run errands after a wedding and is in a rush, waiting for all of it to be over. The girl who caught the bouquet seems to be happy. Can't say the same about her man, though.
Gemma versus Gloria. There's only two. There's two horses in this race. One's Gemma, one's Gloria.
No, what? Oh, no, it's Marys.
You are.
What? Gemma.
Craig, how you feeling, mate?
Honesty is the base of every successful relationship, and yes, that includes talking about dumps too.
You look amazing.
Class is less strict than the registrar's office during marriage these days. Best way to bond with your mother-in-law, in my opinion. This might be this man's villain origin story or sexual awakening. Who knows?
Hey, buddy. And also, as well, go slow. Give her a little dance. Kids, close your eyes.
I don't know. I don't know.
About to cue the music up, making memories. Hey, hold on, hold on. No, no. Mama, step back. He got to do a little dance.
Looks like a sign from the universe for sure.
Yeah, have the rings.
Oh my. No. No. You know what? Something fell in. Something killed before. Oh, I can't believe it.
She gave the dog the ring, the dog accepted it. Logic says she's engaged to the dog now, or that she'll be sifting through his poop for the ring every day.
Okay, Thor. Thor. Come here. Come here. Sit. Sit. Stay. Stay.
Thor.
Oh!
Now that's a fruity individual right there. Click on one of the videos on your screen right now.